is basically an online version of your favourites. But instead of using single hierarchical folders to categorise your bookmarks, you assign multiple keywords or tags. Those tags then provide hyperlinks to a list of all the other items in the system that have been attributed that tag. So while people mainly use social tagging to organise and access their own stuff more easily, by making those bookmarks and tags public online, they can be browsed by other people to find other items of interest and to find other people who share those interests. So how are other academic libraries already using this? Well, some are developing their own bookmarking systems to facilitate personal information management, resource sharing, and collaborative working amongst their members. And here we've got an example of PenTags, which was developed by the University of Pennsylvania. And those of you who are familiar with Delicious might think that this is quite familiar. Other libraries are integrating tagging into their library own packs. And at the bottom here, you can see there's some tags that one of the students there has added to this library record. The idea is that that increases findability and also resource discovery. Other libraries still, such as the London School of Economics, are using existing online social tagging systems to provide subject guides. So here they've embedded the resulting tag bound into their own library webpage. So if I was to click on the tag newspapers, for example, it would take me to a list of items bookmarked and assessed by LSE librarians in Delicious. So you might ask, well, how is this going to work in my library? Well, I think it depends on what your local users perceive to be the benefits of your proposed applications, and also, of course, on their willingness to tag. So to investigate this at Anglia Ruskin, I decided to do an online student survey to find out who's already using social tagging, why they're using it, and how they're using it, and if they're not using it, why. I also followed this up with some student focus groups, where I asked the students to have a look at the examples that I've just shown you and to assess what the benefits and barriers might be. So, from the survey, came up with a short user profile, and just under half of the survey respondents already use social tagging. They tend to be younger students on talk rather than research programmes, and the highest percentage of users were in the Faculty of Arts, Law and Social Sciences. So familiarity and use. Well, use tends to be confined mainly to popular online social tagging sites, so things like Facebook, Twitter and YouTube. So it's mainly social networking and content sharing sites that we're using at the moment. So consequently, most of them are using them daily for personal rather than work or study purposes. And they're mainly using them to organise their own resources, communicate and share links with known others, but not so much for collaborating and networking with other users online. The biggest barrier to uptake of social tagging, rather than people thinking it's too difficult or time consuming to use, it's actually because they don't actually know about them. So at focus groups, the overwhelming preference was for the LSE guides that I showed you. So it's librarians doing the tagging rather than users. And not surprisingly, they liked the guide because it gave them easy access to authoritative, subject-specific resources, and it therefore saved them a lot of time and effort. They also preferred it to Google. And one of the participants summed this up brilliantly because she says, using a guide like the LSE guide, it's like finding the handsome prince without having to kiss all the toads, which I thought was brilliant. There is, however, concern that some students, rather than using these guides, not the LSE guide, rather than using them as a springboard to do further independent research, might actually become over relying on them and expect us just to provide everything for them. When it came to data pen tags and Franklin catalogue, they actually compared these to Amazon, Google and Wikipedia, and they didn't actually like the user contributing content. They felt it was unreliable and therefore also unhelpful. They also said that they didn't think that they would contribute content themselves, mainly because of the time and effort involved. And they were also worried that other students seeing their contributions would either ridicule or criticise them. They were also a bit hesitant about sharing links because they were worried that this was that other users might gain from their contributions without actually sharing anything themselves. And they were also worried about using other students' contributions because they thought this might lead to accusations of collusion and plagiarism. Students were also particularly resistant to the idea of mixing subjective comments with authoritative entries in library catalogues. They didn't like that at all. So for Anglia Ruskin University at least, the evidence seems to suggest that if they're going to adopt social tagging, they really need to concentrate their efforts on applications which facilitate access to quality online resources, rather than looking to try and inspire students to use participation and collaboration. Any application is also going to need to be supported by some degree of user education to promote the benefits, rationalise the concerns they've got, and also to manage their expectations about what we're going to actually provide. So lastly,